In a final ruling, Taiwan Supreme Court has ordered that the KMT return to the nation a parcel of land with an estimated worth in the billions of NT dollars.
Nearly three decades ago, the party illegally shifted ownership of the land from the government to a corporation that controlled it.
This prime real estate, located near the new Banqiao Special District, New Taipei City, still has several antennas left over from the Broadcasting Corporation of China. Years ago, most of this 17,000 square meter parcel was vacated. Little is left apart from a parking lot.
If this land is rezoned as a residential or commercial area, I'd give a rough estimate of it being worth more than 10 billion NT.
The land was originally acquired by the Ministry of Transportation and Communications from the former Japanese colonial government. In 1981, management shifted to the Broadcasting Corporation of China, which was run by the KMT. In 1985, the corporation gained land ownership rights. Now, the Supreme Court has ruled that the KMT must return this valuable asset back to the nation. It is a major victory for former Premier Yu Shyi-kun, who led much of the fight to recover stolen party assets.
The courts have finally given the Taiwanese people due justice. We should use this opportunity to return all the KMT's assets to the people.
According to former Control Yuan member Huang Huang-hsiung, the KMT still has five parcels of land and three buildings that were acquired illegally and should be returned.